Hello there, Matt with LINBIT here, and in the following video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can get started using LINSTOR with Kubernetes. If you're unfamiliar with LINSTOR, LINSTOR is an open source block device management software created by LINBIT, which was designed to make building, running, and controlling Linux block storage simple. You can head over to LINBIT.com and read all about LINSTOR's features and architectural details there. But for this video, we're going to dive right in. I'm starting with a freshly installed 3-node Kubernetes cluster with Calico deployed as my CNI, but that's all I've done, as you can see in the terminals here. LINSTOR for Kubernetes is deployed as a collection of containers or pods using LINSTOR's operator. This stack can be deployed and managed using Helm. If you don't have Helm already, you can install it using this simple one-line command. With Helm installed, you can add LINSTOR's charts repository, found at charts.linstor.io. Some components of LINSTOR are held in private Docker image registries, which is only accessible by LINBIT's customers. If you're not a LINBIT customer, you can still use LINSTOR in your Kubernetes clusters by deploying LINSTOR's community-supported version, which goes by the name Piraeus. The installation steps for Piraeus are nearly identical to what you'll see here, and you can find the Piraeus operator project on GitHub under the Piraeus Datastore org. Or even better, contact LINBIT to become a customer or start a free evaluation. You'll get access to LINBIT's engineers, private Docker images, and more, but back to deploying LINSTOR. In order to access LINBIT's private Docker registry, you'll need to create a Kubernetes Docker registry secret, and it must be named dearbdiocred. This command will show you how you can define that in Kubernetes. Obviously, these are not my credentials, so I'll cancel this command and enter mine in an off-screen terminal. But with our secret created, we can begin deploying LINSTOR. LINSTOR requires a database to store its cluster information. This can be an existing MariaDB, Postgres, or etcd database. Detailed information on configuring LINSTOR's database connections can be found in LINSTOR's user's guide. We'll be using a host path persistent volume template provided in LINSTOR's Helm charts for standing up a persistent etcd database to keep our demo and deployment simple. To use this, you only need to pass the PV host path template your Kubernetes node names, just like this. And you should see you have some persistent volumes defined in Kubernetes. When the LINSTOR operator deploys its etcd database, it'll use these host path volumes to persist its data. The last thing we need to do before deploying LINSTOR is decide how to configure LINSTOR's storage pools. A storage pool is just what it sounds like, a logical pool of storage on a physical node from which LINSTOR can dynamically provision volumes. The LINSTOR operator for Kubernetes can auto-consume any unused block devices that are greater than 1 gigabyte in size and do not contain a partition table. The resulting storage pool from an auto-consumed block device would be named using the same name as the device itself. So an unused dev SDB would become a storage pool named SDB. This is how I'll deploy LINSTOR into my demo cluster, and I'll do that with the following command. This will tell the operator to use thinLVM to pull up our auto-consume storage. And we can watch our pods be deployed. More on storage pools as these ready up. You could choose to pre-configure the storage layout on your Kubernetes nodes, define it in YAML, and then feed that YAML definition into Helm during the deployment of LINSTOR. LINSTOR can really be as simple or as finely tuned as you need it to be. I recommend checking out LINSTOR's user guide or even reaching out to LINBIT directly for more specific information on your planned setup. With everything ready, we can configure some storage classes in Kubernetes and finally start using LINSTOR. Quickly, let's take a look at some classes I've prepared. We can see I've defined three different storage classes, each using our SBD thinLVM pool, with the difference being how many synchronous replicas of our volumes LINSTOR should provision. LINSTOR will use DRBD to replicate the data in these volumes as many ways as set in the autoplace parameter of our storage class. We'll apply these definitions and see we have three new storage classes in Kubernetes. Now we're ready to use our storage classes. I've prepared a standalone Redis configuration that'll use the LINSTOR storage class as its persistent storage. And when we apply the contents of this YAML, Kubernetes and LINSTOR will handle the rest for us. We see we have a pod creating and a pod running. We can take a look inside of LINSTOR by exec-ing into the controller pod. And listing our LINSTOR resources. And we see that LINSTOR is managing Redis's dynamically provisioned volume. And there's plenty more to explore from here. Again, I would highly recommend checking out the LINSTOR user's guide at linbit.com or reaching out to LINBIT directly for more information about what LINSTOR is capable of. That's all for now, though. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.